Hey everybody, so in this video I'm going to talk about my work setup, accessories that I use to complement my work computer. Now I'm not talking about my home actual desktop. I have a computer inside my office. I'm talking about more when I work on the go. And I work on the go a lot because I like to work at coffee shops and I'm always traveling. So I usually take a laptop or an iPad Pro or a PC Windows tablet on me and just work on the go. But I generally mostly use the MacBook Pro because one, it's the most powerful computing device I own, and two, because I edit a lot of videos and I just think Final Cut Pro on a MacBook Pro is just the best software. And on iPad there's Luma Fusion and that's also very good. So I just think Apple's ecosystem has the best software for video editing. But if you're familiar with my work, you know that I actually don't like to use an iPhone. I carry an Android phone on me most of the time. But for work, for editing videos, I mostly use a MacBook. Now, this doesn't mean I love this laptop. I think it's ridiculously overpriced. And I hate this freaking keyboard. This stupid, like, keyboard with no travel, with minimal travel. Apple calls this the butterfly keyboard, and it sucks. Every time I type on this, it pisses me off. And also, this is a 13-inch screen. It's a little bit too small for me. I prefer to work with something bigger if I'm doing a lot of video editing, or sometimes if I'm writing long articles and I need to do a lot of research. But I don't want to splurge on a 15-inch because you know Apple products are overpriced. So fortunately, I live in Hong Kong, which is 45 minutes from Shenzhen, and Shenzhen, it's a city in China where all the tech hardware is made. Your iPhones, your Huawei phones, your Xiaomi phones, like MacBooks, whatever Dell laptop, they're most likely made in Shenzhen. That place is the tech hardware capital of the world, and there's like hundreds, if not thousands, of companies out there right now trying to build gadgets and products. So I have several products that I think are pretty cool that helps me get around the shortcomings of the MacBook Pro. So the first gadget I use is this little portable monitor. This is a 15.6-inch display. It's a touchscreen too. But check out how thin it is. It's super thin, super light, and all you have to do is plug in a USB-C cable and it can connect to MacBook Pro and become a second monitor. This thing can actually connect to just about any gadget you can think of. It can connect to a PS4, it can connect to a Nintendo Switch, it can even connect to a Huawei phone and then just use Huawei's EMUI desktop on the spot, which I'll show you later. But first, let's set up on the MacBook Pro. So the Vinpox Split, it's actually still in crowdfunding stage right now. It's a really, really new product. I believe you can get it now on Indiegogo for $199. They've already raised over $900,000, so they're close to hitting a million. So this thing, it's fully funded. So in addition to this monitor, you get this little magnetic cover that snaps onto the back and provides protection for your device, and it also works as a little propping stand. So I usually prop it up like this. And it comes with a USB-C to USB-C cable. So all I gotta do is plug in one end and the other end, plug it to my MacBook Pro, and it should immediately power on the Vinpoc laptop and then right here. And then I have dual monitors and I can bring files over here. Or if I open up Safari, I can drag the window over here. So now the Vinpoc Split has 1080p resolution, so not as crisp and punchy as the MacBook Pro's main monitor, but if you're using this as a second screen, I think it's fine. In fact, the cool thing is the Vinpoc Split has its own built-in speaker. So if I play a video right on this screen, it will just sound come out of this screen. I can have the MacBook on mute and it'll still be fine. So see, sound is coming out here right now. My MacBook Pro has no sound coming out. That's pretty cool. And I think the display looks perfectly fine. Oh yeah, and as I mentioned, this is actually a touch panel. So that's awesome because I can't even touch the screen on my MacBook Pro, but I can touch the screen here. So now, as mentioned, the Vinpoc Split can connect to just about any device that can output a screen. So if I plug it into the Huawei Mate 20 Pro, EMUI desktop starts up because Huawei's software has a desktop mode. So you see, I plugged it in, now it's gonna start up. And just like that, I have a full-on desktop, and I can use the Huawei Mate 20 Pro screen as a trackpad. How cool is that? Now I can open apps in like small Windows view, I can move them around. So now if I pair a Bluetooth keyboard with the Huawei Mate 20 Pro, I can use it as a computer. So that means if I'm out and about, I just have to bring this Vinpoc Split with me. You know, it's not too big. I can fit into my backpack and make sure I have a small foldable keyboard, which I have one, and then that's it. I know I will always be able to have a computer experience because I always have a phone on me. So back to my MacBook setup. Now, remember, I hate this keyboard though. I don't want to type on this keyboard. So luckily, Vinpoc also released a keyboard too. So this is the Vinpoc Taptec. It sells for $89 right now. It's a mechanical keyboard. So mechanical keyboard means each individual key has a mechanical switch. That means there's a lot of key travel. That means when you type on it, you get a more of a tactile feeling, and each individual key bounces back at your finger. So this keyboard can be connected to my MacBook via cable or just Bluetooth. So I've turned it on. All I have to do is hold down two buttons to begin the pairing process. So you see now this corner light, it's lighting. That means it is now in Bluetooth mode. So I just have to go on my MacBook. Yep, it is connected. Now with this setup, I can type. I have two monitors, but I don't want to always reach over to use the touch screen or use the trackpad, so that means I need a mouse. So I have this here. This is the Lo-Fi mouse. So Lo-Fi, it's another company in Shenzhen. It's separate from Vinpoc. Vinpoc is one company in Shenzhen. Lo-Fi is another. So I'm using multiple different gadgets here. So this mouse is designed just for the Mac, and you see I have a very vintage retro vibe and a lot of buttons. I'll show you what they do. So just gotta turn it on. I've already paired the mouse, so it should pair right away. So yeah, here we go. So you know the two buttons right here in the wheel are pretty much self-explanatory. The wheel is to click into things, and then the right mouse button is to bring up the submenu, and then the wheel is to scroll up and down. But there's actually also this little ball that allows you to shrink or enlarge a web page. And you can also do this for photos, I believe. I haven't tested yet, but I'm trying. Yep, you can also zoom in and out of photos. And there's one more button here. This lets you simulate the three-finger swipe gesture of a MacBook. You know, when you swipe your finger left and right, you go between apps. So to activate it on the Lo-Fi mouse, you just simply press the button and then you move left and right. Now I can move between Spotify and my Chrome. So if you're using this on the go, some at a coffee shop that won't give you an outlet plug, or if you're using this, I don't know, at a park somewhere, and you need to charge your MacBook Pro, you need something heavy duty. So I have this. So this is the Jackery Power Brick. Jackery is yet another brand in Shenzhen. Like I said, everything comes out of Shenzhen these days. So this thing is freaking huge because it has a 77 watt hour battery inside. That's a little bit more than 20,000 milliamp hour. So that means it can charge your smartphones like four or five times over. Or you want to charge your MacBook Pro, it can charge it 1.5 times. So you have a Quick Charge 3.0 port here. You have a USB-C port that supports input and output and power delivery. So you can charge this thing or charge other things with the USB-C port. And you have another USB port right here. So you can charge like up to three things at once. But best part, this actually has a universal outlet on the back. So this outlet supports every type of plug. Whether you live in Hong Kong, Japan, Spain, China, Korea, Italy, your plug will work on this. So let's test it out. Okay, so I have a charging brick here. So I'm gonna plug in the USB-C into the MacBook, and I'm gonna rip out the US plug. And once you power on, there's actually a fan inside to, keep temperature cool. So I have to just plug it in, just like that, and my MacBook is charging. So now with this setup here, I basically have a system that is somewhat portable, but still allows me to get a lot more work done than just with a standard laptop. Now I know you're probably thinking this actually isn't that portable. If I bring this monitor with this keyboard, with the mouse, and the battery and the MacBook, that's actually quite heavy and the bag will be full. Yes, that's true. I agree with you. So this isn't meant to be lugged around all day. So I think the setup is good for someone like me who often works out of a coffee shop or at a hotel because I travel so much. So if I'm going to a coffee shop just down the street from my house, then I know I'm only lugging all these things for like 2 minutes, and after that I'll just go back home and drop it off. Or if I'm at a hotel, then it doesn't matter if it's a little bit bulky. I just have to put all this in a suitcase when I travel. Or conversely, this system could be useful for someone who work at one of those new hipster startups, because new offices nowadays, they don't give you a whole desktop station. They usually give you a laptop and then you can work anywhere. So if you're one of those people, this Vinpoc Split helps a lot, and I think this keyboard helps a lot too. So the Vinpoc Split, it's on Indiegogo right now for $199. I think for this price, it's a good deal, because not even as a secondary monitor, I just love that I can plug an internal switch into this and just play games, or I can watch movie off of this, or just plug my Huawei phone into it and have a desktop experience on the go. This keyboard from Vinpoc sells for $89, and while this Jackery charging brick, the name is so funny, Jackery, sells for $105 on Amazon. And then this mouse here, I'm not even sure if it's on sale yet. I don't know how much this is, but it should be under $80. So this is the low-free mouse. Anyway, this is my setup for now. Thanks for watching.